to you by Penguin.
The Bridge, written and read by Donna Lancaster. If you always look up and never down, you will be seeking your whole life from the heavens for something that was always meant to be found in the dirt. The Welcome, a prayer for the worthy. That means you. I welcome each and every one of you and every part of you. The part of you that feels anxious and afraid. The part of you that is full of rage. The part that feels excited and curious. The part of you feeling shut down and disconnected. You are welcome here. I welcome the part of you that feels heartbroken and overwhelmed. The part of you that feels too broken to ever heal. The parts of you that feel fake and those you know are real. You're all welcome. The parts carrying your trauma, the body carrying your soul, the abused and violated parts too, the addicted you and your shadowy layers, the secret carrying guilt-filled shameful parts, guess what? Welcome. The part of you that has been hurt and has hurt others, made mistakes, screwed up big time, and the resulting self-loathing and low self-worth. Oh, you are all so welcome here. For the parts of you that are confused and lonely, the ones that feel they can't go on another day, and yet they do. And for the courageous you that gets back up again and again, and those parts of you that yearn to live in love and truth. The parts that remember everything. Welcome. And welcome to the queen in you who has forgotten her crown. Welcome to the innocence of you and the joyful part too. You are all so beyond welcome. Yes, all parts of you are welcome. You belong, you matter, you are worthy, you are loved. And I'm so very glad that you came. Introduction. Everybody hurts sometimes. Face down on the floor in a ladies' loo might seem like an unlikely place for personal transformation, but that's where mine began. The day I experienced my breakthrough began as a day like any other. I took my children to school and then I drove to work, my mind already on my caseload. I was a social worker working in child protection and felt compelled to do everything I could to help vulnerable children. My mind would buzz day and night with their stories. As I was parking my car that morning, I noticed that my heart was beating very fast. My breathing was shallow and my palms were sweaty. What's wrong with me? I thought impatiently. I haven't got time for this. As I entered the building, I began to realise I was in serious trouble. I was sweating heavily, my heart was pounding and I felt really sick. I stumbled into a staff toilet and locked the door. Pain flooded my chest. Was I having a heart attack? I sank to my knees and began to sob. I was terrified that I was going to die. On a dirty toilet floor of all places. Oh, the glamour. Pain coursed through my whole body and tears poured out for what seemed like hours. Eventually, I lay face down and surrendered to my fate. I don't know how long I was lying there, but eventually the pain and tears subsided enough for me to stand up on my wobbly legs. I splashed water on my face and tried to work out what had just happened to me and what I should do now. Was I out of danger? I felt wired. There's no way I could work. I dragged myself out to my car, my whole being focused on my need to get home. I couldn't think beyond that goal. I took some deep breaths and I started the car. I set off, very slowly. I never went back to the office after that day. I was signed off sick for 3 months and eventually decided I could not return to social work. I didn't realise it then, but my transformation had begun. I had hit rock bottom. The only way from here was up. In diagnostic terms, it was a panic attack that I was suffering from that day, over 20 years ago now. But in a way, my hunch about a heart attack was more accurate. My poor heart had been shattered so many times and so completely over the years. I was exhausted, burnt out, and the cumulative weight of my unhappiness had become unbearable. Although my mind had refused to acknowledge this devastating truth, my body found a way to make me feel it. Although this experience was agonizing at the time, it was also my way out of the half-life of the walking wounded that I'd been existing in for the best part of 30 years. I didn't know it then, but I had found an opening, a portal to a very different way of living, right there in the darkness of my pain. It took courage, heavily laced with desperation, to decide to crawl through it and begin my journey towards the life I live today. Which, let me be clear, is not all sunshine and rainbows, but is most definitely a life of authenticity, lightness, and truth, where I do not pretend to feel or to be something I am not. This is my version of a wholehearted life. My deepest hope is that this book will enable you to discover your own. Everyday heartbreak. Every person's life has its sorrows and struggles. We all know this on some level, and yet we are often blindsided when painful things happen to us. The shock we might feel at the unexpected ending of a significant relationship, for example, can leave us feeling helpless. Sometimes we are surprised a particular event has hit us so hard. If a casual friend cuts us off without explanation, for example, that can feel more hurtful than we would have predicted. Many of us don't realise the impact of the smaller losses or hurts in our life. Hurt and loss come in so many forms, from being teased at college to being passed over for promotion, to failing an exam, to falling out with our grown-up children. Whatever our stage of life and personal circumstances, all of us experience everyday heartbreaks and would benefit from being better equipped to deal with them. There are a lot of misunderstandings about loss, as we will see throughout this book. Many people understand it to mean bereavement. I will be showing you that the death of a loved one is not the only loss that needs to be grieved. Far from it. That's why I also use the slightly different term, heartbreak, to refer to all our significant pains and losses. For some people, heartbreak makes them think of the loss of romantic love. For me, it encapsulates the visceral reaction to any painful event that hurts our heart and leaves us feeling bereft, wounded, or abandoned. The events may be different for each person, but the feelings they provoke tend to be similar for many of us. Anguish, fear, anger, disappointment, sorrow, confusion, guilt, to name but a few. These are just some of the emotions that make up the complex human experience called grief. My work has shown me that these feelings, though uncomfortable and potentially damaging if left unexpressed, are pretty much universal. We will all experience loss and feel grief at some point in our lives, perhaps many times. Fortunately, most of us will also feel happiness, contentment, joy, and wonder. They're all part of being deliciously human. Our heartbreaks and our grief, however, can also teach us to live a more authentic and wholehearted life.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.